Namaste students, welcome back to my channel. In our previous video, we have studied about various interesting facts about the oxides of nitrogen. Well, which oxide is used by the dentist, which oxide is known as anhydride of nitrous acid, which oxide is known as anhydride of nitric acid. The last oxide of that particular video is dinitrogen pentoxide, which is known as the anhydride of nitric acid. So today our topic for this topic is nitric acid. We'll study all about nitric acid in detail. Yes, I know you know the formula of the nitric acid, that is HNO3. It is an acid, you all know about this, but I'll tell you some interesting facts in this video which are not known by you. So without any delay, let's get started. Friends, our topic is nitric acid and the formula of the nitric acid is HNO3. Now, you all know that this HNO3 is known as oxoacid of nitrogen. Yes, this HNO3 is known as oxoacids of nitrogen. Now, what do you mean by oxoacid? This is known as oxoacid of nitrogen. Now, what is the meaning of the oxoacid? Oxoacids are the acids in which the replaceable hydrogen is attached with the oxygen. So oxoacids are those type of acids in which the hydrogen, replaceable hydrogen, is attached with oxygen. Those acids are known as oxoacid. So the nitric acid is also an oxoacid, and this nitric acid is the oxoacid of nitrogen. Now, if I talk about the nitrogen, nitrogen form three oxoacids, means we have three oxoacids of nitrogen. Now, the three oxoacids of nitrogen are, first is hyponitrous acid. First one is hyponitrous acid. Now, the formula of the hyponitrous acid is H2N2O2. And if I draw the structure of this hyponitrous acid, the structure become N double bond N, single bond OH, single bond OH. Now, in this case, the hydrogen is attached with the oxygen. The replaceable hydrogens are attached with the oxygen. That's why it is known as oxoacid. Next oxoacid is nitrous acid. Next one is nitrous acid. Now, the formula of the nitrous acid is HNO2. The formula of the nitrous acid is HNO2. And its structure is N double bond O, single bond O, single bond H. Its structure is N double bond O, single bond O, single bond H. And third, that is the main oxoacid of the nitrogen, that is nitric acid. Its formula is HNO3. And if I talk about the structure of HNO3, it is HONO, O positive, negative. Or one more resonating structure is possible, that is negative, positive and double bonded O. So, nitric acid is the oxoacid of nitrogen. What is oxoacid? Oxoacids are the acids in which the replaceable hydrogen is attached with the oxygen. Nitrogen form three oxoacids, hyponitrous acid, nitrous acid and nitric acid. The formula of hyponitrous acid is H2N2NO2, and this is the structure of the hyponitrous acid. The formula of nitrous acid is HNO2. This is the structure. And the formula of nitric acid is HNO3, which has two resonating structure, because one structure can't able to explain all the properties of the nitric acid. So in this video, we have to make focus on nitric acid. So, first of all, we'll talk about the preparation of nitric acid. First of all, we'll talk about the preparation of nitric acid. Now, we have two different methods for the preparation of nitric acid. First one is the laboratory method and second one is the commercial method. So, first we'll talk about the laboratory method. Now, in laboratory, in lab, HNO3 can be prepared by heating a mixture of KNO3 and concentrated H2SO4 or NaNO3 and concentrated H2SO4. So, in lab, HNO3 can be prepared by heating mixture of KNO3 or NaNO3 and concentrated H2SO4. So, the reaction means the reaction which we get is KNO3 plus H2SO4 on heating, it gives HNO3 plus KHSO4. This is our laboratory method. And if I write the reaction with NaNO3, so the reaction becomes NaNO3 plus H2SO4 on heating gives HNO3 plus NaHSO4. So, this is the reaction. Now, if I talk about the second method, that is commercial preparation. Now, commercially HNO3 can be prepared by the Ostwald process. In our previous videos, we have mentioned the first step of this process many times. Like in the formation of NO, that is nitric oxide, we mentioned this, or the reaction of ammonia with excess of air, we have mentioned the first step of this process many times. So, in Ostwald process, we have three steps. We have three steps for the preparation of ammonia. First step is ammonia reacts with excess of air in the presence of platinum and rhodium at 500 Kelvin. To form NO plus H2O. Then this NO again reacts with O2 because here O2 is in excess. So this NO reacts with O2 to form NO2. And this NO2 reacts with H2O to form HNO3 plus O2. So the HNO3 which we get from this method in the third step, actually this is very dilute HNO3. Means we get HNO3 from the Ostwald process, but the HNO3 is in very dilute condition. So we have to concentrate that particular dilute HNO3. So first of all, the aqueous HNO3, dilute or aqueous, that is the same thing. So the aqueous HNO3 is concentrated by distillation. To get 68% by mass of HNO3. So, aqueous HNO3, first of all, the HNO3 which we get from the Ostwald method is high, is in dilute condition. So, the aqueous HNO3 is concentrated by distillation. First, we use the method distillation. So, by distillation, we'll convert this dilute HNO3 up to 68% HNO3, and then from 68% to 98% means the concentration from 68% to 98% is done by using concentrated H2SO4 as a dehydrating agent. Up to 68% we'll use distillation method, By distillation method, we'll get 68% by mass of HNO3, and we'll convert this mass to 98% by using concentrated H2SO4 as a dehydrating agent. Concentrated H2SO4 is a dehydrating agent. So in this way, we'll get 98% by mass of HNO3 through the Ostwald process. So these are the two methods through which we can prepare ammonia in the lab as well as for the commercial purpose. So this is the introduction of the ammonia. This one is the preparation of ammonia. Now, if I talk about the physical properties of the ammonia, nitric acid. So, first of all, the nitric acid is a colorless liquid with a pungent smell. Pungent smell means the smell is very pungent, just like of that of the ammonia. In ammonia, we have studied that the ammonia have very pungent smell. Similarly, the nitric acid is a colorless liquid with a pungent smell. But in your laboratory, sometime you saw that it is yellow in color. Means the color of the nitric acid becomes yellow. So the yellow color of the nitric acid indicates the impurity in the nitric acid. If we have pure nitric acid, that nitric acid is colorless. But if we have impure nitric acid, that nitric acid is yellow in color because of the formation of the oxides of nitrogen. Some particles of the nitric acid get converted into the oxides of the nitrogen, and due to the formation of the oxides of the nitrogen, the color becomes yellow. So, colorless liquid with a pungent smell when it is present in its pure form, but when it is present in its impure form, it is yellow in color, and yellow color is due to the oxides of the nitrogen. And if I talk about the second property, in lab, 68% HNO3 and 32% water. In lab, 68% HNO3 and 32% water acts as an azeotropic mixture at 394 Kelvin. Now, what are azeotropic mixture? Azeotropic mixture are the mixture which boils like a pure liquid. Because in mixture, we know that each component has its specific volatility. So, different components form vapors with different speed. As a result of which, they will not boil like a pure liquid. But in our lab, 68% HNO3 and 32% water behave as an azeotropic mixture, but at a particular temperature, and that temperature is 394 Kelvin. So these two are the physical properties of nitric acid. Now we'll deal about the chemical properties of nitric acid, which are very important. We have a number of chemical properties of nitric acid, but we will study some important one only. The very first important property of nitric acid is decomposition. Nitric acid undergoes thermal decomposition to give nitrogen oxide, nitrogen dioxide, and oxygen. So the reaction becomes HNO3. On heating, it gives NO2 plus O2 plus H2O. So, nitric acid undergoes thermal decomposition to give NO2 plus O2 plus H2O. Now, the second property of the nitric acid is acidic nature. Now, because of the presence of one replaceable hydrogen, we have studied the structure of the nitric acid. The structure of the nitric acid is HON. Double bond O, single bond O, negative, positive. So due to the presence of the one replaceable hydrogen, it acts as a monobasic acid. It acts as a monobasic acid means the acid whose acidity is whose basicity is 1, so it is monobasic acid, and because of its monobasicity, because of its basic basicity, it reacts with carbonates, bicarbonates, hydrogen carbonates, oxides and hydroxides to yield a single type of compound known as nitrate. So it reacts with oxide. Like if I write a reaction that HNO3 reacts with calcium oxide to form CaNO3 whole twice, that is calcium nitrate plus H2O. This HNO3 reacts with Na2CO3, that is carbonate, to form NaNO3 plus H2O plus CO2. So here also I get the compound related to nitrate family. Next, HNO3 reacts with NaHCO3 to form NaNO3 plus H2O plus CO2. So, because of the monobasic nature, this nitric acid reacts with oxides, hydroxides, carbonates and hydrogen carbonates to yield a single type of a compound which is known as nitrate. So, this is the second property of the nitric acid. Now, the third property of the nitric acid, which is very important property, that is oxidizing agent. Oxidizing agent. It acts as an oxidizing agent. Now, nitric acid in dilute as well as in the concentrated form, in both the form it acts as an oxidizing agent, because in both the form it decomposes to yield the nascent oxygen. For example, HNO3. Here I am taking dilute, and HNO3, here I am taking concentrated. So HNO3, when it is present in its dilute form, it forms H2O plus, H2O plus nascent oxygen plus, because it is dilute, it forms NO. And it forms H2O plus nascent oxygen, because it is in concentrated form, therefore it forms NO2. So, in both the forms, we get water and nascent oxygen. But if we have dilute HNO3, we get NO, that is nitric oxide. And if we have concentrated HNO3, then we get NO2. If you remember in our previous video, while we are studying the properties of the oxides of nitrogen, we studied that NO can be prepared by heating copper with dilute HNO3, and NO2 can be prepared by heating copper with concentrated HNO3. So from there you get to know idea about, if we have dilute HNO3 we get NO, and if we have concentrated HNO3 we get NO2. Now we'll study the part of the oxidizing agent. And the first part is the oxidation of non-metals. Now, if I talk about non-metals, in non-metal, there is no effect of dilute HNO3. Means dilute HNO3 do not oxidize non-metal. So there is an effect of only and only concentrated HNO3 in non-metal. For example, if I write certain reactions, that is C plus HNO3, it gives CO2 plus H2O plus, now because it is concentrated HNO3, so in concentrated HNO3, I'll get NO2. Similarly, suppose if I have I plus HNO3, it gives HiO3 plus H2O plus NO2. Why I get NO2? Because again, the HNO3 is concentrated, because there is no effect of dilute HNO3 in the oxidation of non-metal. Third, if I talk about T4, P4 reacts with HNO3 to form H3PO4 plus H2O plus NO2. If I talk about arsenic, arsenic reacts with HNO3 to form H3AsO4 to form and H2O plus NO2. So these are some examples of the oxidation of non-metal. So in HNO3, if I talk about in HNO3, the oxidation state of HNO3 is, the oxidation state of HNO3 is 1 plus X minus 6, that is X equals to plus 5. And in this, the oxidation state of nitrogen is plus 4. So itself undergoes reduction and As becomes oxidized. So in this way, the concentrated HNO3 oxidizes the non-metal. So I am repeating the statement again that there is no role of dilute HNO3 in the oxidation of the non-metal. Only concentrated HNO3 can result in the oxidation of a non-metal. Now next, second part, we will talk about the oxidation of compounds. Oxidation of compounds. Now, if I talk about the oxidation of the compounds, both dilute and the concentrated HNO3 can result in the oxidation of the compounds. For example, if I have H2S, that is hydrogen sulfide, as a compound, when this hydrogen sulfide reacts with dilute HNO3, when this reacts with dilute HNO3, then it get oxidized to S, H2S get oxidized to S, we get H2O, and because it is dilute, so we get N. Because it is dilute, so we get NO. Similarly, when this H2S reacts with concentrated HNO3, then this H2S get oxidized to S plus H2O plus, because this one is the concentrated nitric acid, therefore we get NO. This is the main difference. This is the only difference. Otherwise, the oxidizing product is the same product. Similarly, if I have FeSO4, when this FeSO4 reacts with dilute HNO3, then it gives Fe2SO4 whole thrice plus H2O plus, because it is dilute, so here it is NO. And next, if I talk about FeSO4 plus HNO3 concentrated, then what is the product? Now you tell me. Now this is your turn. You tell me that when FeSO4 reacts with concentrated HNO3, what three products we get. If I talk about the third product, that is a different kind of product, that is C12H22O11. When organic compound reacts with HNO3, whether it is dilute or concentrated, it forms COOH, that is oxalic acid plus H2O plus NO2. In this we get NO2 because it is organic compound. So when we talk about organic compound, when organic compound is treated with HNO3, whether it is concentrated or dilute, we get NO2. But if we talk about the inorganic compounds, so when inorganic compounds reacts with dilute HNO3, we get NO, and when they reacts with concentrated HNO3, we get NO2. So this is the oxidation of the compound. Now third, we'll talk about the oxidation of the metals. Now oxidation of metals we'll study in three different topics. First one, the oxidation of the metals which are more reactive than hydrogen. Second, oxidation of metals which are less reactive than hydrogen. And third is the oxidation of noble metals like gold and platinum. So first, we'll study about the oxidation of highly reactive metals. Highly reactive metal means those metals which are reactive than hydrogen. Those metals which are reactive than hydrogen. Now, if we have 2% dilute HNO3, if we have 2% dilute HNO3, with 2% dilute HNO3, we have two such metals. Which metals reacts with dilute HNO3 to liberate hydrogen gas? In our previous classes, we have studied that metal when reacts with HNO3, they do not liberate hydrogen gas because HNO3 acts as an oxidizing agent and it converts H2 into H2. Therefore, we didn't get H2 gas when metal reacts with nitric acid. But we also studied at the same time that we have two exceptions, magnesium and manganese. When magnesium and manganese reacts with very dilute HNO3, there is a condition for magnesium and manganese also. It is not so that if you are treating magnesium with concentrated HNO3, it liberates hydrogen gas. It doesn't liberate hydrogen gas. When magnesium and manganese reacts with very dilute, 2% dilute HNO3 means in 100 gram of solution, we have only 2 gram of nitric acid. So when the magnesium and manganese reacts with 2% HNO3, then they form nitrate and liberate a hydrogen gas. So the reaction becomes Mg plus HNO3, and this HNO3 is 2% dilute. This HNO3 is 2% dilute. So magnesium plus HNO3, it gives MgNO3 whole twice plus H2. Then it gives MgNO3 whole twice plus H2. And similarly, when manganese reacts with HNO3 and the HNO3 should be only 2% dilute, then 2% dilute acid means 2% HNO3 by mass. 2% dilute acid doesn't mean only 2% water we have. 2% dilute acid means 2% HNO3 by mass. So then also it gives MnNO3 whole twice plus H2. But if the concentration of HNO3 is greater than 2, then this magnesium also doesn't liberate hydrogen gas. It forms nitrate, but it doesn't liberate hydrogen gas. It liberates water and one more product, which product we'll study now. So now in this we'll study first the reaction of these metals with cold dilute HNO3. With cold dilute HNO3. So, if I talk about magnesium, if I talk about zinc, if I talk about iron, so magnesium, zinc, iron, when they react with cold dilute HNO3, then they form the corresponding nitrate, liberate water, and a compound which is known as ammonium nitrate. Since it is dilute HNO3, but we didn't get here nitric oxide. We didn't get here nitric oxide because it is very cold and we are treating with the metals. So when iron reacts with HNO3, which HNO3? Cold and dilute HNO3, then it forms FeNO3 whole twice plus H2O plus FeNO3 whole twice plus H2O plus NH4NO3, that is ammonium nitrate. So when iron, zinc, magnesium, they reacts with cold and dilute HNO3, then they reacts means when the metals which are more reactive than hydrogen, they reacts with cold and dilute HNO3, they form ammonium, they form that particular nitrate along with the ammonium nitrate. But here we have one exception, and that is lead. Here we have one exception, and that exception is lead. So when lead reacts with HNO3, then it forms PbNO3 whole twice plus H2O plus NO. It forms N. Lead forms NO, but other metal forms ammonium nitrate. Clear? So when HNO3, cold and dilute HNO3 reacts with metal, reacts with the metals which are more electropositive than hydrogen. So it reacts with the metal to form the corresponding nitrate along with the ammonium nitrate. But when it reacts with lead, then it forms the NO. So this exception you have to learn. This exception you have to keep in your mind. Now, next, if I talk about hot dilute HNO3. Next, if I talk about hot dilute HNO3. So with hot dilute HNO3, this NH4NO3, due to the presence of temperature, decomposes to form N2O. Decomposes to form N2O. So our reaction becomes with hot dilute HNO3. Our reaction becomes Fe plus HNO3 gives FeNO3 whole twice plus H2O plus N2O. From where we get this N2O? From the ammonium nitrate. So on heating, the ammonium nitrate decomposes to yield N2O. So the reactions remain same, but through this we get N2O. So this is when we are reacting the highly reactive metals with the cold dilute HNO3. Now we will react the highly reactive metals with concentrated HNO3. With concentrated HNO3. So when the metals accept tin, when the highly reactive metals accept tin reacts with concentrated HNO3, then they form the normal product, means nitrate, water, and because it is concentrated, so they will form nitrogen dioxide. For example, Mg plus HNO3, then it forms MgNO3 whole twice plus H2O plus NO2. But in this, we have an exception, and that exception is tin. We have an exception and that exception is tin. So when tin reacts with HNO3, then it forms H2O. It forms H2O, but it doesn't form tin nitrate. In place of tin nitrate, it forms SNO2.H2O, that is metastatic acid. So in place of nitrate, the tin forms metastatic acid. So with highly reactive metal, if we have 2% dilute HNO3, magnesium and manganese react to form nitrate and hydrogen gas. With cold dilute HNO3, all other metal forms ammonium nitrate except the lead, which form NO, that is nitric oxide. And if we have hot dilute HNO3, then all the metal form N2O, because when we are heating the system, the ammonium nitrate get converted into the N2O. And if we have concentrated HNO3, then all other metal form the common product, that is nitrate, water, and the NO2, that is nitrogen dioxide. But tin is the only metal which reacts to form metastatic acid, H2O and NO2. So this is the oxidation of highly reactive metals. Now we'll study the oxidation of less reactive metals like copper, silver and mercury, which is a simple reaction. So second, we have to study the oxidation of the metals which are less reactive than hydrogen, Now suppose I have copper. When this copper reacts with dilute HNO3, then it forms CuNO3 whole twice plus H2O, and because it is dilute, it forms N. Same reaction with the silver and the mercury. Silver reacts with dilute HNO3 to form silver nitrate plus H2O plus NO. Mercury reacts with dilute HNO3 to form mercuric nitrate, H2O and NO. But this reaction occur in two steps. In first step, the copper reacts with dilute HNO3, then it forms CuO. Because these metals are less reactive metal, so these metals doesn't directly get converted into nitrate. First they convert into oxide and then the oxide get converted into the nitrate. Though the final product is nitrate, but this reaction occurs in two steps. In first step, copper get converted into copper oxide and then copper oxide get converted into the copper nitrate. Means Cu plus HNO3, it gives CuO, and then CuO plus HNO3, then it gives CuNO3 whole twice. So from this we get the product. Here we get NO and here we get H2O. So the reaction occur in two step, but the simple the overall step is this one. Now if I react copper with concentrated HNO3, then it forms CuNO3 whole twice plus H2O plus NO2. The common reaction. Similarly, if we have silver, then silver reacts with concentrated HNO3 to form silver nitrate. The formula of the silver nitrate is HgNO3, silver nitrate plus H2O plus NO2. And if we have mercury, then mercury also reacts with HNO3 to form mercuric nitrate plus H2O and NO2. So this is the overall reaction. This is the overall reaction or the reaction of the metals when reaction of the nitric acid when it reacts with metals which are less reactive than hydrogen. Now in third, we'll talk about the reaction of the nitric acid with noble metals. Noble metals are the metals whose reactivity is very, very, very less. For example, gold and platinum. Now, in our previous video, we have studied about the aquaresia solution. What is aquaresia solution? Aquaresia solution is a solution in which we have three part of HCl and one part of HNO3. So, aquaresia solution can dilute gold and platinum also. So, how aquaresia will act, we will study in this topic. Now, HNO3 plus HCl means three part of HCl and one part of HNO3. When they react, then they form NOCl plus H2O plus Cl. Means they will give nascent chlorine. And when this nascent chlorine reacts with gold, it forms AuCl2. And when platinum reacts with this nascent chlorine, it forms PbCl4. So when we combine these two, we get nascent chlorine. When we apply the mixture of this, the nascent chlorine reacts with gold and platinum to form AuCl2 and PbCl4. And because HCl is in excess amount, so AuCl2 reacts with HCl to form HAuCl4, which is orochloric acid. And this is the soluble part. Means this dissolve in the aquaresia. Because of the formation of this, gold dissolve in aquaresia. Similarly, this PbCl4, it reacts with HCl to form H2PbCl6, which is chloroplatinic acid. And chloroplatinic acid we have studied earlier also. Where we have studied chloroplatinic acid? Chloroplatinic acid is the acid which we can use for the detection of the ammonia gas, because it reacts with ammonia to form ammonium chloroplatinic acid and gives yellow color PPT. So in this way, platinum and gold dissolve in aqua regia, and hence gold and platinum can be polished by using aqua regia. So in this way, aqua regia act on the noble metals, that is gold and platinum. So these are the oxidation reaction of the metals: highly reactive metals, less reactive metals, and the noble metals. Now we'll study next property. Now we'll study the next property, and the next property is nitration. What is our next property? The next property is nitration. In our 11th class also, we have studied about the nitration. That is, the mixture of HNO3 and H2SO4 is known as nitrating mixture. So, third property is oxidizing agent, which we have studied. And the fourth property is nitration. Now, the mixture of concentrated HNO3 and concentrated H2SO4 acts as an nitrating agent. Nitrating agent. And why we use concentrated H2SO4? Because concentrated H2SO4 help in the formation of the electrophile of HNO3. That's why we use concentrated HNO3 along with concentrated H2SO4 along with concentrated HNO3. Now, first, if I talk about the nitration of the benzene, So, here is the benzene. When benzene reacts with HNO3 in the presence of H2SO4, both are in concentrated form, then it forms nitrobenzene. Next, If we have toluene, then toluene reacts with HNO3 in the presence of H2SO4 to form trinitrotoluene. That is TNT. NO2, CH3, NO2, NO2, and NO2. So this is trinitrotoluene, that is TNT. Clear? Why? Because of the presence of these two nitrating agent. Nitrating agent means which provide NO2 group, that is nitrating agent. Now next, if we have phenol, then when phenol reacts with HNO3 in the presence of H2SO4, then we get picric acid. OH, NO2, NO2, and NO2. This one is the picric acid. Clear? Similarly, if it reacts with glycerin, that is CH2OH, CHOH, and CH2OH. When it reacts with glycerin, then it replaces the hydrogen. And form either dinitroglycerol or trinitroglycerol. O-N-O-CH-O-N-O-CH-2-O-N-O. Clear? This is trinitroglycerol or CH2O NO CH OH CH2O NO. So this is trinitroglycerol and this one is dinitroglycerol. Now this TNT and trinitroglycerol, these two used as an explosive agent. agent. These two use as an explosive agent. And if I'm not wrong, you have heard about the dynamite. Now, in dynamite, we have a mixture of trinitroglycerol and dinitroglycerol. What we have? Mixture of dinitroglycerol and trinitroglycerol absorbed in Kieselguhr. Kieselguhr. Now, what is Kieselguhr? Kieselguhr is actually a light soil which contains siliceous diatom, and often used as a filter material also. So, it is a kind of a soil, a light soil which contains siliceous diatom as an impurity, as a component. So, when dinitroglycerol and trinitroglycerol is absorbed in this soil, this form a component of the dynamite, and dynamite is used as an explosive agent. So in this way, these acts as an explosive agent. An explosive agent we can prepare by the nitration of some compounds by using HNO3 and H2SO4. So students, we have done with today's lecture. In this lecture, we have studied many interesting things about HNO3. If you have any query, if you have any difficulty, then comment me, then send me the message in the comment section. I'll surely solve your query. That's all for today. I'll see you in my next video with new topics.